Let's do a new beginning. A new beginning. A new hope. Hey, everybody. It's Record Time with Chris, episode, well, I don't know, 54 or something. But there's no number because this is the big Record Store Day 2019 video. Now, some of you only watch my Record Store Day videos, and that's cool, but a lot of you kind of watch stuff all year long. So for those of you who don't know, I do these kinds of things, you know, all year long, and but I get to stretch out a little bit more and talk more about the releases, get a little more in-depth. So if you have been following all the Record Store Day videos that I've done in the last month, you can skip ahead a little bit because this is all stuff that you've already seen. Well, actually, now that I think about it, maybe I haven't shown everything. Like, I don't know if I showed the freebies in one of the videos that I already published. Anyway, I should point out that if you look down below here, you go for, you know, more info. If you expand it, there is a little timeline where you can click right through to, you know, whatever stuff you're looking for. Let's start with this. There is a Record Store Day tote bag every year. This is this year's, and some stores, I think some stores, will have their logo printed on the backside. Got some other free stuff in here. There are some Joe Bonamassa guitar picks with one side Record Store Day logo and the other side his name. I used to shop at his parents' store. In fact, Stax Magnet, and I got some Stax stuff coming up in less than a minute. It's a Pearl Jam button. Now, we know Pearl Jam is the ambassador for this year's Record Store Day, and they have a live release coming out. A nice little Mac DeMarco pin to remind us that his new album will be out soon. And there's this nice Record Store Day compilation, a whole bunch of different stuff on it. Compilations. Like I said, we're going to start with a Stax one, Boy Meets Girl. And this is a repress of something that hasn't been available since, about 50 years. It's actually like a concept album, and it's got basically a whole bunch of Stax people in various duets and different combinations, doing love songs. And people like Booker T and the MGs are on here, and Isaac Hayes produced tracks. So it's like that core Stax rhythm section with a bunch of great, great people like Eddie Floyd and Carla Thomas. Black vinyl, 2LP, nice yellow label. It's a nice set. If you're into psych compilations, you know that you kind of buy the same songs over and over a lot of the time. Well, that probably won't happen to you unless you have an enormous collection with this, I think, of Poppies, the assorted finery from the first psychedelic age. And the stuff on here comes from labels like Stax, but also Vanguard. Like, the first track is a really like freak folk kind of thing by Buffy St. Marie, and Original Sound, and I think maybe some other labels that just kind of got like swallowed up by those other ones. Let's take a look at it here. Transparent red vinyl, and there is this really nice four-page booklet that has, you know, like a nice paragraph or two about every track on it. It's a good set. Coal Mine Records presents Soul Slabs Volume 2. This is a 3LP box set on red vinyl, and it's in a really nice heavy slip cover. You can see that there's a picture of Plaid Room Records on the back. That's the brothers who own Coal Mine, also own and run that store. So this will help you figure out what exactly the compilation is. It's a bunch of stuff that they've released on 45. Some of these songs did it also end up on the artist albums, and it's soul, R&B, maybe a little funk. These kind of, you know, in a sort of like a, it's current people who have an old sound. And the backside has just kind of candid photos of the artists. The band everybody usually calls AC. is releasing. There's a reissue of this Picnic of Love album. They're going by AXCX here. And this is like syrupy love songs. They're just kind of trying to do the opposite of what you'd expect them to do, like cuddling a kitten. Now, this is on pink vinyl, but it's got this, there's like an animated etching. You can see here, there's like a, it's like a bunch of hearts that sort of cross over each other. There's another record with an animated etching on it, and I'll tell you about that in a few minutes, and it's by the same guy. Bingo Hand Job was the name that was used by a prominent American artist in 1991 when they did a secret gig in England. And the songs on here are songs like Losing My Religion, The One I Love, right? Radio song, pop song. So you kind of probably could guess who it is, but they have sort of fake identities on the back. They're just like traveling wheelbarrows. It's titled Sanitized for Your Protection, and there's actually a little band on here to show that it is indeed sanitized. So one side of the, there's one side of the picture sleeve is black vinyl, and the other side has like sort of like a set list, I guess, kind of written out. And here's another clue if you haven't figured out who it is. The songwriting credits are to Barry, Buck, Mills, and Stipe. Elvis Costello and the Imposters. This is a 12-inch with four songs that he wrote or sort of wrote with other people. So Burt Bacharach, Paul McCartney, Bob Dylan, and Johnny Cash. I don't know how many of those he was in the room for with them, or where they sent him lyrics and he came up with the music. But they all sound like they're from the same sessions. And on the back, there's a little ad. It looks like it says here, watch this space. So there must be another Elvis Costello thing coming out that we don't know about yet. Nice four-color sleeve with, notes, lyrics, ad for the current album, which is Look Now. Here's the one with the etching, and this is going to take me a little while to explain. So the artist is, it's Cool Keith with musical accompaniment by Phaeton. Now, you may not have heard of the band Phaeton, but the guy who plays bass and keys in the band is Dan Emery from Black Matter Mastering, and he's the guy who does those really complicated etchings. So, like the AXCX one I showed you, but this one is like over the top. So, now, Caroline Harrison is the artist. She does a lot of album art, I guess. And he realized this picture of hers. It's kind of hard to show it what it is. And the side with the music on it has all these crazy features on it. This is the A side of the record. And you can see here, there's another one of those animated etchings. This is where the main song is, but for fun, there are two different versions of the song, and depending on where you put down the record, you'll get one or the other. Then there's a little bit of blank space. There's a locked groove right here at the end, so it doesn't keep going. Then where it says here, it says Octagon, Elvis, Doom. Those are the like personas that Cool Keith does on the record. This, if you can kind of see, it's a little fuzzy. It's actually a playable etching. There is like a sound collage underneath there. There's an etching under the label, and maybe you can just barely make out some letters underneath it. It says on a road trip. There you go. There's where it says on right there. There's the A on the left side. Lowercase R O A D. See that? Modest Mouse, Poison the Well. It's talked about as a 7-inch, but it's actually 11 inches, the longest dimension. And it's two new songs from their forthcoming album. Don't know much about the album. The record itself is in this nice little triangular snow coney kind of thing. Here's what the back looks like, by the way. The record itself, nice triangle. And the label on the back's pretty cool. It's similar to, but not exactly the same as the old Vertigo Records logo that, it had a lot of prog bands and the Black Sabbath to begin with. So Leon Russell, live album. You know, live at Gillies or Jilly's. I probably should have figured out what exactly it was before doing this. And it's, what you'd expect. It's like about 1980. It's a live album. He's got kind of country-ish band, and does a couple of the songs that he's best known for. There's a Santana 7-inch. This is from the upcoming album that was produced by Rick Rubin. Both these songs, I think, will be on the album, and Small Hole. Here's stuff that's not on the album. Tedeschi Trucks Band. It has three studio recordings that were left off their most recent album, and one almost 12-minute-long version of the song live, 12-minute-long almost live version of a song from that album. And did I show you the back? Here's the back, and it's on nice, heavy, really clean feeling 180-gram vinyl. It's at 45 RPM, and it was cut by Kevin Gray, so you kind of have all the elements you need for a really great-sounding record. Here's Violent Femmes' second album, Hallowed Ground, and this is an all-analog mastering, folks, so move that a little higher on your list if you were considering it. They're numbered to 2000, and you can see here I have an unnumbered one because it's a promotional copy or whatever. They don't want to take it out of the actual 2000, I guess. And it's on translucent green vinyl. Nick John was Mastodon's manager, and he passed away last year. He was also like a really good friend. Said that, they say on the back, thank you for your guidance, your wisdom, your never-ending hard work and dedication. Thank you for your smile and your infectious laugh, but most of all, thank you for your unconditional love and friendship. We love you, Nick John. Rest in peace. He was a big Led Zeppelin fan, so this 10-inch contains two versions of Stairway to Heaven. The B-side is from his funeral, actually, and the A-side is a studio version. This is Houndmouth, 7-inch. The A-side was written by the guy from Foxygen and Richard Swift. And the B-side's like by the band, but neither of those songs have been available ever. Green Day live at Woodstock. This is the 1994 Woodstock, of course. And first time on vinyl for this back cover. Here we go. And black vinyl. Warner Brothers was one of the first labels to understand what Record Store Day could be. They kind of saw, they helped, they're with us. They just got it. They got it early on. So it's no surprise that every year they have a lot of releases on Record Store Day. In fact, just from within Warner Reprise, lots of times they'll release more than like entire distribution companies who have, multiple labels to choose from. They're enthusiastic about it, I guess, and they also have a lot of good things that work well for Record Store Day. Now, look at this. See this big stack here? This isn't even close to all the Warner Reprise stuff we got. This is just the soundtracks. So we're going to go through a whole ton of these soundtracks. Now, they all have similar packaging. So they're all single pockets. That means it doesn't open up in like a gatefold cover, even though some of these are 2 LP sets. And they all have these four color inserts. And the something I just learned recently from a project I was working on, that it is way cheaper to add one of these than it is to go to a gatefold cover. So this way, they still get to give us some nice artwork, but, you know, if you're talking about somebody who's going to buy a whole stack of records like that, that's like going to save them, you know, 15, 20 bucks probably. You know, that's like another record they could get. And also, you know, we all need more space on our shelves, and so a nice thin jacket will help with that. But what am I even holding? Coneheads soundtrack, and it is on translucent yellow vinyl. I'm gonna give you a close-up of the back cover, and here, just so you can see it, is the nice insert. And this does have some stuff on it that wasn't available elsewhere or hard to find or whatever. Like there's a Red Hot Chili Peppers B-side, which became an A-side, I think, when the album came out. There's a Bare Naked Ladies doing Fight the Power, the Public Enemy song, and you have the first track, Slash, and a guy from Hanoi Rocks, and they're doing a cover of Magic Carpet Ride by Steppenwolf. House of Wax. The vinyl's pretty cool on this, but this one here, you know, this is bands like My Chemical Romance and Deftones, The Prodigy, Disturbed, Marilyn Manson, and some other stuff on there. It is, oh, let me show you the back. Hold on. So notice this. Count how many sides there are right there. Let me show you the insert, and we'll get back to what's going on there. All right. So we have side one and two. Kind of like a weird, sort of like almost sage kind of vinyl. But check this one out. So, you know, side three. Side four has this like black plug in it. I don't know what that's all about, but it's actually like rough here. Can you hear that? Yeah, there's a lip there. And if you look very closely, it's super hard to find, but it is etched. Hopefully we can get some nice glare here and you can get a sense of what the etching is, but it's this drippy stuff. That's what the etching is. On the back cover of the Malcolm X soundtrack, director Spike Lee explains that Malcolm X was a big fan of music. He liked to dance, and he personally knew some of the musicians who are on the soundtrack. Now, with the exception of the first cut, which is Arrested Development, which thematically fits in, everything else is from, you know, like when Malcolm X was an adult. So you got people like the Ink Spots, Joe Turner, Lionel Hampton, Billie Holiday, John Coltrane, Aretha Franklin, Duke Ellington, so on. The insert is, as you see, black and white, and it's not glossy like the other ones. That one is it's like a matte finish, and it's a translucent red vinyl. Next one, New Jack City soundtrack. Of course, it's a hip-hop soundtrack. I mean, Ice-T's in the movie. I think Color Me Bad had the big hit, but you've got associated with the soundtrack, but you have like Keith Sweat and Two Live Crew, Johnny Gill. Well, hey, you can read it for yourself. Here you go. Back cover. Again, glossy thing, stills from the movie, backside liner notes and another image. And this is the one that is silver vinyl. I can show it to you. And when they say silver vinyl, you know, they mean gray. It's not like a metallic thing, because I understand that you can do that, but it sounds terrible. Howard Stern, Private Parts. That cover. This has some stuff that was like explicitly recorded specifically for it. Like there's Howard Stern does something with Rob Zombie. He does something with the Dust Brothers. There's this is kind of cool. So look at this right here. So it's white. The name's whited out, and then you have three members of the Red Hot Chili Peppers. So that's LL Cool J. I don't know why he's covered up on the back, but that's who it is. And Ozzy does pictures of matchstick men with type O negative. Blue vinyl. Type O negative's on another one of the soundtracks we have here. We have soundtracks to three big Transformers movies, and it's kind of neat to see how, like, what was happening in rock. These are not the scores, these are the soundtracks, so it's like rock music for the most part. And it's interesting to kind of see how, like the first one, which was from 2007, you got Linkin Park on here, and Smashing Pumpkins in 2007 was still considered a band you put on a contemporary soundtrack, you know, but Disturbed is on here. And this one is a reddish, whoa, purple vinyl. Looking good there. That's a color you don't see a lot. The next Transformers movie, here we are. It's from 4 years later, and so now you got like Nickelback and Theory of a Dead Man on here, but you still Avenged Sevenfold and a song of Cheap Trick recorded for it. Let me show you this. So green vinyl, as you can see here, and this is, again, it's got that weird, you know, side four has a weird plug in it, and it is etched. It just says Transformers. It's got the subtitle Revenge of the Fallen. Johnny Adams' Heart and Soul. This is a compilation of, you know, his hits from the 60s. Alien Weaponry. This one includes a bonus 7-inch, and there's no sticker on it, but I'm not sure what I think the original plan was that this was going to be like a really cool orange and red kind of splatter, fiery kind of looking thing. Art Ensemble of Chicago. Personally excited for this one. Here's a Rarities album, Badfinger, from just, you know, outtakes from two of their albums, a self-titled one, and then Wish You Were Here, not the Pink Floyd album. Basketball Diaries soundtrack, the gatefold cover. There are actually two reissues of Bird and the Bee albums. There we are. Now, this is kind of a cool story. This B-52's, this was gonna be B-52's second album, and it was produced by David Byrne, but I guess they didn't get along real well, so all they got out of it was an EP, but they released it anyhow. Two Frank Black reissues. This is the first time these would be available on vinyl in the U.S. Buffalo Tom's first album. Here's one of three, I think, David Bowie releases. This is a picture disc based on the 2015 master. And here we are, Fleetwood Mac. Whoops, the alternate Fleetwood. What the hell? Well, I'm confused by it, but I get it. Okay, here's the front cover. Here's the back cover. Different photos of different versions of, you know, the this is kind of funny. Yeah, so, you know, it's different variations on the cover photo, and it's, you know, different versions of the songs from Fleetwood Mac self-titled album. Here's a nice 2 LP compilation. Stax does the Beatles, and it's pretty cool. As you see, we got the descending T right here, just like on the Beatles logo. And this is embossed, and this should, of course, remind you a little bit of the White Album. But it also includes a nice essay by a guy who's, you know, known in the Beatles author world. And the here's tracks for you. You know, it's Otis Redding, Booker T and the MGs, Carla Thomas, you know, Isaac Hayes, a lot of the big Stax people. Speaking of Stax, this is an all analog mastering of the mono mix of Albert King's album Born Under a Bad Sign. It was done by Kevin Gray, I believe. Yes, that is true. And Great Blues album, kind of can't beat it. And maybe just for fun, I will compare this to the old Ultra Disc CD, which I have of that. We'll maybe report later how that goes. This is cool. We're having another print this year. People who get to Bull Moose early will be able to get one of these things. We might just put them right in those tote bags I showed you earlier. Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young, Four-Way Street. This has been expanded with some extra tracks from the CD version of it. Cut by Chris Bellman, so you know it's going to sound good. And as you can kind of see here, there's a whole lot of stuff in there. I think it's just, you know, to hold all the albums. The Crow soundtrack. The score came out a few years ago. Now we've got the soundtrack. And this is the one with, like, The Cure and I think the Nine Inch Nails song on here may not be anywhere else. Anyway, gatefold cover. Should be nice. Culture, some reggae, and the four songs on side two are unreleased sessions from 1983, and he's backed by the Wailers. The Desmond Dekker, totally unreleased album from back in the day. This has got more unreleased reggae for you. It's a Devo box set. Nice, it's their six Warner Brothers albums, and colored vinyl. There's also like a Goo Goo Dolls box set of Warner albums, looks like that, and an Emmylou Harris one. The Emmylou Harris one is like 80s stuff. I had the 70s one from last year. It sounds freaking great. All right, DJ Khaled. First time on vinyl for this. Of course, a lot of that's the case with a lot of these. Same here. Dr. Dre, right? This might have been, you know, based on when this came out, probably some of these were on like 12 inches originally, but you might have had to be an actual DJ to have access to them. It's a live Anderson East album. It's a double album. Sheena Easton. Picture disc. Produced by Prince. Emerson, Lake & Palmer live album from 72. That was in one of the box sets. Van Farlow, two LP set, and side D is a bunch of bonus tracks. Ace Frehley's most recent album is coming on a picture disc. Also have the soundtrack to Twin Peaks Season 2. And this is the original Twin Peaks Season 2, you know, from 1992. Weezer, the Teal album, of course, on teal vinyl. Maybe you've been wondering, where was the teal vinyl on this? Well, they saved it for Record Store Day. Wasn't that nice of them? Peter Gabriel rated PG. Clever title there, because these are all songs of his that were in various movies. A lot of them, you know, not on albums or different versions, blah, 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 blah. It's a picture disc, as you can see, and the back side of it, which you can't see, looks like popcorn, I think. First time The Fall by Gorillaz has been available on vinyl in the U.S. Bunch of Dead-related stuff here. First off is this compilation that was sort of co-done with Dogfish Head Beer. It's supposed to be like a bunch of songs for kind of like relaxing, too. Nice live album here, Warfield. It's two records. It's also going to be available on CD. And here's another Dead-related thing, Good Old Boys Live, and double album, and Jerry is on there. Let's see, we did Green Day already. Beth Hart, front and center, here we are. This is, there's a bonus track on here that was not on the original album. And here's a 2LP Hawkwind double album, 1974 tour, first time on vinyl, even though it says the 1999 party. So hey, huh, that reminds me there's some Prince records too. The Heptones' Swing Low, 1985 album, includes a bonus 12-inch. Here, High on Fire, these are three new songs you haven't heard before. Hockey Dad here on Glow in the Dark vinyl. And this is the first U.S. vinyl pressing of their original EP. Jefferson Starship Gold. And it includes a bonus 7-inch. I can feel it right under here. And I just want to point this out to you as well. Look for records that have this sticker on it. It says, wait a second, not that one. This one. Record Store Fortune Cookie. These are There's a bunch of them. I'll tell you what they are. Aha, Anderson East, Fan Farlow, Jefferson Starship right there, Ramones, the Doors, Tiny Tim, Where the Action Is, that's like LA Nuggets compilation, the Woodstock mono, and which I'll show you in a bit. And yes, all of those have that thing on there. What you do is, there's a code, you get a code, you go to a website, put it in there. It's all like a Warner Music Group thing. And if you you could win, let's see, Audie's LCD2 Classic headphones. They're also giving away speakers by Canto Audio. And also, a whole year's worth of all the Runout Groove releases. So that's going to be pretty. Make sure you know, and it's one of those deals, I guess. The more you buy, the more you can enter. Fela Kuti and Roy Ayers, interesting compilation or collaboration there. Lone Justice, this is all unreleased stuff, brand new live recordings. I mean, it's from 1983, but you know, it's new that you haven't heard it. The Lost in Translation soundtrack, Violet Vinyl. Here is one of the two Madonna 12 inches, and these are all they're continuing with like what they did before with making them and look like the old Japanese style. I've really been enjoying people's reactions to the RSD3 mini turntable. Here's the box it comes in, and I posted a much longer and more detailed video on Monday, so go back there if you want to see it in more detail. But let me show you some cool things about it. First of all, and this is a great example of how a lot of it's done, there's a little cutaway thing in the packaging here that holds the Foo Fighters record that comes with it. They could have just thrown it in, but you know, they did something to protect it so it wouldn't get banged around. Now, what is it? It's a little 3-inch record. And here you are, it comes in a nice plastic sleeve. And you get, here is the poster. There you go, nice poster. And the record itself is in a paper sleeve. Take it out, there's the sleeve. Here you go. And you see it is a darling little 3-inch record. You see the Roswell Records logo. This is the Foo Fighters song. Now the turntable itself is right here. And as you can see, it sort of reminds you of like a Technics player from the 80s. It's cute and tiny. On the back, there is a, you can see there's a USB in for power and regular output, just like a headphone out. There's a battery compartment on the back. It takes 4 AA batteries, which I have in here. And the cover lifts off. You can see here, this is, so the turntable itself is actually felt. And the Audio-Technica cartridge with a cartridge protector there, it's nice. You've got speed control. And when I turn it on, a nice little light comes on. You can probably hear it swirling, but I will play it for you. There's another detail I want to show you. There's this little 45 RPM like adapter that needs to go on the spindle. You can store it up here if you like. And they give you an extra one in the package, which is great because how are you going to find another one of those if you lose one? It comes with all the cables that you'll need, including a nice adapter to go from like a headphone jack style to headphone plug, actually, to RCA. And this is a great thing to just have. You'll need it sooner or later anyway if you have stereo. And there are more records that you can buy. There are two bundles, sets of four. Epitaph has this one with Culture Abuse, The Interrupters, Rancid, and Bad Religion. It's four in here. And they're coming to stores packaged in a complete set of four. Third Man Records has one as well with Jack White, Raconteurs, White Stripes, and Dead Weather. And there's another record coming which will be available just by itself. It's the Japanese song, like a classic, like in the way that like a Frank Sinatra song would be a classic for us. It's the song Sukiyaki. And the records are going to end up retailing for about $10 each, and there will be more later on this year. Let's look at some soundtracks now. Got I Know What You Did Last Summer, and this is the soundtrack, not the score. It's got the Typo Negatives cover of Summer Breeze, and it's on red vinyl. And you get, there we are. One side of each record has a track list, and the other one has an image from the film. The second record has just a small cropped version of this photo. Knight Rider soundtrack. This is with new art, and it's been expanded to a full double album. You know, I think it was just a single cassette originally. There's Kit. This one's black vinyl, but it has nice color inner sleeves. You can see with these schematics of Kit and nice track lists and details what episode all the different cues were in. And the other record has another picture of Kit and again the same list of cues. The Krypton soundtrack is on really cool looking orange and red vinyl. Let me show it to you. It's called Galaxy Vinyl, and what I like about it is that it's got those splotches on it. You know, it's not so much it's just a different kind of look, you know. Here's the Star Trek soundtrack. This is from the first of the reboot, J.J. Abrams, and it's black vinyl with a nice four-color inner sleeve. The Sopranos soundtrack will be available on vinyl. This is a double album on what they're calling Prozac and bourbon. No, Prozac and booze splatter vinyl. I cannot tell you what color that's supposed to be. Here's the South Park Bigger, Longer, and Uncut soundtrack. As you can see, it's expensive, but it's also huge. Now, it's a double LP, and depending on which version you get. Oh, let me show you. See, they're numbered. So the first 1 through 2500, those will be on red and orange vinyl. And the other 2501 to 5000, that's on green and blue vinyl. And each record is inserted into like a die cut image of one of the characters. And so if you get the blue and green one, you get Kyle and Stan, and it's Cartman and Kenny are in the red and orange one. There's also a 28-page lyric booklet inside, and there's the lenticular image on the cover is really complicated. There's at least five or six different layers to it. So I think that's where a lot of the expense comes from. It's also very heavy. And there'll be 10 people who buy this. There'll be a golden ticket kind of thing where you can win a print autographed by Trey Parker and Matt Stone. You know, there's 10 of those. I'm not too sure exactly what someone who gets the color correction credit in a film does, but if they're trying to get continuity of colors across different shots, man, you could see how bad a job I'm doing. It's really hard, you know, with different light coming in, because obviously this is an office setting. You don't have a video studio here. So anyway, it's one of those things, you know, until you try it, you don't realize how hard somebody else's job is. Speaking of, here's a good segue for you. So there are two James Brown-related releases, and one I can't show you. Its show is funky down here, and the reason I can't show you it is because the stamper broke during production, and so there are fewer copies were made than expected. It means I don't have one here to show you. But what that does mean, though, is that you'll have an easier time finding it. Like, if you can't find it on Record Store Day, don't sweat it, because it'll be easier to find afterwards. So don't panic if you can't find it. I can show you the other James Brown related thing, and I'm going to put gloves on just because, I'll show you why when we get to the spot here. The album is, the band's credited to the Grodeck Whipperjenny. And this was the first album that was released on one of James Brown's imprints. This one is called Peoples. James Brown produced it, and the main guy in the band is David Matthews, not the one you're thinking of. This guy did a lot of funk and jazz stuff. He ended up as a jazz producer, but this record's pretty cool. So there's some funk to it, but it's also definitely like forward thinking, and there's a lot of weird stuff on here. Definitely cool if you're into being challenged a little bit. Now again, as you can see, black vinyl, and there is this really nice booklet. And this is why I'm wearing gloves, because it's black and I don't want to get finger marks on it. You can see that both albums are referenced on the cover. So this is the story really of both of them, and it's your typical, whatever. It's a nice, it's on the nicer side, more complete side of, booklets that accompany albums. There is a really, so you get what you expect, right? Pictures of tape boxes, photos from the sessions, whatever, and a really long, nice, good essay about both albums and this period in both James Brown and David Matthews' lives. It's nice. And now I can take these off. Chuck Mosley. He was the front man in the original Faith No More lineup. He was in Bad Brains in the early 90s. And this is his final recording session. The B-side is a cover of a Faith No More song, and A-side is his version of Nothing Compares to You, the Prince song that Sinead O'Connor had a hit with. These are like acoustic versions, stripped down, with some like percussion and stuff added. One thing that's cool about it is it's a main-based label that put it out, and black vinyl. Another New England situation here. Czarface. Two of the guys, 7L and Esoteric, are from the Boston area, and Inspecta Deck is the other guy that they do this with. And like their previous releases, it's a book and record set. So there are two stories, two sides to the record also, of course. The music itself is sort of like blaxploitation soundtracks, but through a hip-hop filter. So it's very cool. The stories are actually kind of funny, and they involve the Czarface character, who's a superhero, but he's like Batman in the sense that or Wolverine, like he's willing to get violent, but unlike those guys, it's harder for him to pull back and not want to, like the first story is about elephant poachers, and he wants to be pretty cruel to them, understandably, right? So here's a rare reggae reissue. Dillinger is the artist, obviously, and if you're into reggae, you might know the song Cocaine on the Brain, which was a hit. It's on black vinyl, and they have reproduced the Mango or Island style label. Rudy Ray Moore, there's a movie about him coming out on one of the streaming services, so you may miss it. But anyway, Eddie Murphy's playing him, so you're definitely going to be hearing about Rudy Ray Moore. He was, so he does, like, he's like a, combines like soul music with that, you know, kind of filthy 70s humor that, you know, didn't end up on like television or whatever. Like, you know, like people like Red Fox would do. When he, not in the Sanford and Son context, you know. Anyway, you can see what it's all about here. I'll show you the, and it's pretty cool because they're you know, obviously it was on a very small label, and they've reproduced the all the, you know, the way the original thing looked, including down to where it says here, available on tape, 8-track and cassette. You may recognize him because his Christmas album came out. I think it was last Black Friday, or maybe 2018. I think it was 2018, not 2017. This is real exciting. Pete Rock is starting his own record label, and he has this enormous vinyl collection. So, he, of course, he's going to start it off with vinyl. There's going to be a lot of vinyl releases in it, and it's so it's really cool of him to launch it on Record Store Day with this return of the SP-1200. And that's the sampler model that he used. And these are all beats that were never used, dating from the 1990s. The Game Face 7-inch on yellow vinyl has a nice two-sided black and white insert. Those are both two newly recorded songs for this Record Store Day and the B-sides of Tom Petty cover. Here is a Youth of Today 7-inch with a Partridge Family cover and Sex Pistols cover. Again, colored vinyl. And there's a black and white insert here as well. Neither of those have been on album before. This album, Steve Gadd Band, just won a Jazz Grammy. It's a gatefold cover. We also have this here, Green Jelly, the Serial Killer album and soundtrack. Gatefold, it's also first time on vinyl, 1,500 copies, and it's clear with glow-in-the-dark splatter vinyl. And we know one track has two guys from Tool and Les Claypool on it. That was the one with the video, if you remember that. Griot Galaxy was a jazz group from Detroit. This was recorded in 1982, never been out since then. And the label was Black and White Records, so the record is black and white. And it's a third band thing, so, you know, there might be some, it might not be a real super strictly a Record Store Day thing by the Record Store Day rules. Everybody else has to follow. I'm not sure of that. The records that I've opened up were all sent to me, you know, for promotional purposes for this video to show you, and I don't need them all, so I'm going to start giving stuff away again on the regular Record Time with Chris videos. So if you're not subscribed, you might want to do that, because I think in the next one, which will probably be, I'll probably be tired and I probably won't get to it till like the first week of May, but I will, I'll just give away a whole bunch of this stuff, like, you know, through the comments or whatever. Yeah, that could be fun. That could be fun. And I got a ton of other stuff that would just be, you know, neat to, I don't know, give out to people, like what, I don't know, whatever, like that. You'll see. The Dream Syndicate, The Days of Wine and Roses, includes two, maybe three records, because it's the original album. There was a 12-inch EP released around the same time, and it had 7-inches as well. Cold War Countdown. This is like underground country tracks from 1952 to 1972, all Cold War themed, the war side and peace side. Want to briefly mention here, though, that's on that's the same people who do those Hillbillies in Hell compilations, Iron Mountain Analog Research, and they always do a great job. So that's one, like, you know, that's one of those things, like, if you're wondering about it, you'll probably like it. Creepazoid's soundtrack The liner notes, they say the soundtrack might be better than the movie. We have The Essence. Hillbillies in Hell, that's another country compilation, obviously, about that tends to focus on, oh, this is going to be, oh, Pete Drake's on there. That's funny. Usually it's people that you've never heard. Oh, Porter Wagoner, Johnny Paycheck. Yeah, so these are people you know. Anyway, these are always really good. There's Procol Harum, self-titled album. This is a reissue of the U.S. mono version. It has a replica of the original poster. It's a gatefold cover. No, it's not a gatefold cover. It's just a bunch of stuff stuffed in there. And there's a second record that has, like, you know, outtakes and single mixes and, like, stuff from, you know, other versions of the other releases of the album, like in other territories. Vinyl debut of 7 Mary 3's first album. And same thing's going on with Kenny Wayne Shepherd's first album. Here we are. Some of these might be colored. No, this is not colored. It's just the fact that it exists at all is why you care. You probably have music by Bernard Purdy somewhere in your collection. I'm sure you do, because he was a session drummer who's amazing, who was on all these like funk and jazz albums and like getting to do some rock stuff. He sampled a ton, so like any hip-hop album, you know, he's all over the place. So this is a solo album of his. He did a few solo albums in the early 70s, and it'll be funk and stuff. And it's by Tidal Waves Music, which is a label that, you know, another one of those labels that always does a real nice job, in my opinion. Here's the Sopranos Peppers and Eggs soundtrack. The next seven releases I'm really showing more for the UK and European Union viewers. They're official releases for you. They're not official in the US, but a small number of them will be available. Might be hard to find, but so yeah, if you're in Europe, you're gonna be able to get some stuff that's gonna be hard for us to do. So, Africa Addio soundtrack, 1966 movie, and the US title was Africa Blood and Guts. Brother Theodore. Now, I don't know what, I want to get this myself, but I don't know, I have no idea what it sounds like. All I know is that he was kind of like, he was hilarious whenever he guested on David Letterman. The Cable Guy soundtrack. First time on vinyl, I think. Yes, it is. Here we have, Fuzzy Haskins. He was in P-Funk. Some early days of that, the funk solo album. Metavari, or I always have trouble pronouncing their name. Yeah, Metavari. They are known for doing like electronic versions of like alternate soundtracks to movies. And this particular one is stuff for the short films of David Lynch. You know, like the weird ones, the early ones. You've seen them, I'm sure. Okay, Power of Zeus. This is funk rock from 1970. And the Silvers. Obviously, you've got a nice soul record here. So now we're going to go back to U.S. exclusives that, you know, might be available in other places too. I don't know. Depends on the rights. I'm going to do a lot of 7-inches for you now. Starting with Baby Shark Picture Disc. We've got Goblin, a song called Yell that is, I think, really super rare. Lord Huron redid the big song The Night We Met, and Phoebe Bridgers is on it, who just released an album in early March. Yeah. A couple different Motorhead 7-inches. There are two in this package. Ocampo, Ocampo, and Watt. That's, of course, Mike Watt, amazing bass player. Here's a Pelican 7-inch, and they have an album coming out this summer, and there's an indie exclusive too. Not sure what's on it right now. This is red vinyl though. There's two 45s in here by The Police. One of them has its Message in a Bottle is a song, and there's a previously unreleased instrumental mix of the song, in case you'd want to hear it that way, I guess. Iggy Pop Saxon box set with 4 or 5 7-inches in it. There you go. Look how nice and thick that is. That'll be cool. The human switchboard. This, as you can see, well, I mean, you can't see. It comes with like a zine, but it's a 7-inch tucked inside of a zine. Gonna make you feel like it's the 90s again. There's Anderson .Paak Bubblin'. B-side is a remix with Busta Rhymes on it. There's a really cool Aretha Franklin album of singles, actually. Album in the old-fashioned sense that it's... there are 5 singles and each one has... It's like in its own page that's stitched in here. And they're all from 1967, so it's like Respect, Chain of Fools, A Natural Woman are the three big ones. Pretty cool set. This is enormous, but awesome. Al Green. You can see that it, well, you, maybe you can't tell, but it's in a like a linen finish box. Linen's, you know, glued down to the cardboard. There's, of course, the gold foil stamp there. There are 26 7-inches in here, singles of his. There's a 56-page hardcover book. It comes with a little, you know, a small hole, a big hole, 45 RPM adapter. And this was made by Fat Possum, who you may have heard has a couple record printing presses of their own now. So chances are they made sure this sounded really great. Bohemian Rhapsody, I'm in Love with My Car, 7-inch from the movie, of course, and it's purple and yellow colored vinyl. KT Tunstall, this is pink, and this stuff is new to the US. Wallows, Link Ray, previously unreleased recordings. This is one of the 2 Madonna 12-inches that are reissues of Japanese versions of them. Got a 12-inch by Old Dirty Bastard on yellow vinyl. It's a Lee Scratch Perry record. Gatefold. Justin Courtney Pierre. He's from Motion City Soundtrack. PJ Masks Live. So this is something, you know, they're touring right now or touring this summer. So I guess your kid likes to go watch people in, you know, suits or whatever that they've seen on the internet or on TV. There you go. But it'd be a fun record. Robert Plant. I don't think it's been on vinyl for a real, real long time. And here's a RZA album. Blue vinyl, I think. Smoke vinyl. Birth of a Prince. And it's, you know, gatefold cover. Big Sugar Hill Records box set. 6 12-inches. Obviously, key hip-hop innovator, creator of it, right? Here's a Sun Records compilation. These are curated by stores that participate in Record Store Day every year. We're up to volume 6, and the theme on this one is that all the artists are female. Here's a Tangerine Dream record. There's another Tangerine Dream one also. Cecil Taylor, gatefold double album. This is part of ORG's series of reissues from the Freedom label. So a whole bunch of Art Ensemble of Chicago and other stuff that's coming out of Record Store Day. But they're doing it all, you know, all the time. Got a bunch of new songs by Thrice. Jeff Tweedy, Warmer. These are studio tracks that were recorded around the same time as Warm, his most recent album. And so a whole unreleased album. And here is Yes's first album. I think it might be all, yes, it is all analog, cut by Kevin Gray. If you've heard Kevin Gray's other cuts of Yes albums, like Close to the Edge and Fragile, Drama, I think he did all those. Chris Bellman might have done one or two of those. Anyway, they all sound like really, really great. So you'll want that if you want that. Here's a mono mix of the Woodstock soundtrack. It's still three LPs, but they've added some extra stuff that wasn't on the original version. It's in mono, and you can see they have one of these like cool DJ stickers on there, as well as a warning to listen carefully before you play it on the air. And another thing about this, I think this is set up the way it would have been originally with sides A and, well, say sides 1 and 6 on the same record, and 2 and 5 on the same record, and 3 and 4, you know, so you could put it on your turntable with the your record changer. So you could play sides 1, 2, 3, flip it over, 4, 5, 6, right? Yes, that's how that worked. Here's an Allman Brothers record. This was recorded by Bear, who is more like very famous taper from Grateful Dead circles. He did a bunch of other stuff too, and this is the first one with the Allman Brothers. This is a 1970 Fillmore East concert, so it's like, you know, Statesboro Blues, Mountain Jam, In Memory of Elizabeth Reed. So pretty exciting. It is an all analog mastering, and it's a gatefold cover, comes with a glow-in-the-dark poster. Now, I think the quantities on this ended up lower than maybe they could have been, but this isn't your only chance at buying this, so don't pay stupid money for it on eBay or whatever. You'll have another chance. We have a Louis Armstrong, or Louis Armstrong, when you want to be a little more respectful about it, doing songs from Disney movies. One new song by Courtney Barnett. Battlefield 5 picture disc. This is the cooler side. We have the Bolden, two songs from the Bolden soundtrack. Wynton Marsalis plays it, of course, and these are, that's the only vinyl release for that. There's no other record. It's just CD and digital if you want the whole thing. First time on vinyl for this Bone Thugs and Harmony album, East 1999 Eternal. It's two LPs on white vinyl. Here is the Brazil Classics box set. As you can see, there's a thinner slip cover than you sometimes get. Three records. And if you don't know the story behind these, I think it came out of, like, David Byrne just used to make mixtapes for his friends of Brazilian music. He was just really into it. And at some point, somebody said, you know, you should, like, license that and get them actually released. So that's where his label, the Waka Bop, came from. And so, it would be like, you know, the anthology of American folk music. Something like that. Like, it was that important in world music circles, just to introduce people in North America who were not familiar with anything beyond, like, the Girl from Ipanema to the whole awesome world of Brazilian music. Here's Canned Heat, live at Woodstock. It's red vinyl, and as you can see, this part is die cut into the shape of a can. That's a new remix, and then the old, like, B-side with the, like, long, whatever, 70s, long disco mix. Alice Cooper, 2005 album, first time on vinyl in the U.S., and it's like red blood spatter. Got Death Grips here. This was a digital EP originally, so that's your first chance to get it. In physical format, no CD on that, and Depreciation Guild right here. This compilation is called Disco Not Disco. It's a three LP set. It's a reissue of that. This came out on CD like around the year 2000. And it's, you know, it's stuff like Yoko Ono, if you know, the Walking on Thin Ice, like, disco version that she did. So it's all like dance, like experimental weird dance stuff, I guess, like Material, Was Not Was, and even the Don Cherry on here. It's pretty good. It also says it's mastered loud for dance floors. Here's an entirely new Dr. Dog live album. Anderson East has a live album as well. This is one of those ones with the fortune cookie inside where you can maybe win some cool stuff, headphones and speakers and a bunch of Run Out Groove records. I address it later, other point in the video. Like the editors, Blank Mass Sessions, and these are remixes of stuff from the last album, plus one song that was recorded at the same time that didn't make the album. Folk and Pop Sounds of Sumatra, Volume 2. It's gatefold cover, double album, and I think it's on Sublime Frequencies label, who always do a really cool job with like unusual international releases. John Grant, this is a bunch of remixes. This Groundhogs album, there's two different versions of it. This is the more deluxe one. The other one is like, I think it's a white cover. I didn't bring it. And this one just has some extra stuff in it. Oh, Radio 1, that's what it is. There's a whole record worth of Radio 1 recordings that, but if you're like, yeah, I don't have $31 for Groundhogs, you can just get the regular album, straight reissue of the regular album. This is kind of cool. Insides was it was released on an offshoot of 4AD in 1993, and if you're not real familiar with them, it very much has that early 90s, late 80s 4AD sound with, like, you know, lush backing, female vocals, and, you know, not as a, sometimes kind of ethereal, slow, like real pretty, and there's like some like fair amount of electronics, but it's pretty organic sounding. Just mention it that if you're not familiar with this record, but you kind of like that type of stuff, you should definitely consider it. This John the Martyr record, is the only way you can get this is on vinyl, and it's on School Kids Records, and I'm not sure if that's associated with the store School Kids, but it would be pretty cool if it was. And not unsurprising. Not surprising. Sundays has a nice little thing for us. It's the best of Little Walter. Now, he played harmonica on tons and tons of blues recordings in the 50s and 60s, like total, you know, super important guy. But this, believe it or not, is the only actual 12-inch album that he was released in, under his own name during his lifetime. So it's a bunch of, it's a collection of, you know, singles, hits that he had had. Los Lobotomies is a double album, and this group I think was put together as a joke, but it's like session people from LA, but let me tell you who's on there. So it's like, it's a couple people from Toto. You got Will Lee, who is the bass player on David Letterman's band. Joe Sample, who's a like jazz pianist, and yeah, weird, huh? Anyway, it's a bunch of covers. Here's Mission of Burma. I think this is their oldest stuff, and it's just nice to see good old New England label Tang releasing stuff again. Moon Express. This is for people who like weird old previously unreleased recordings. Just if you're into that. So they were, the only way you might have heard of them is they were in a Monkees movie, but they recorded a whole album that never came out. And it's also being released on CD on Record Store Day, if you need to compress your budget a little bit. But the record includes a 7-inch with two Beatles covers on it. Morgan, and this album was released digitally last year. No CD, that's the only physical version of it. I have kind of a classic soundtrack here, No Alternative. And, you know, it was, you know, Mudhoney and bands like that. It's like grunge and alt rock. Here we have Fish Heads, the song Fish Heads, which you may know from, if you know it, you know it from Dr. Demento, probably. So it's got the original version of it by Barnes & Barnes, which is Billy Mumy, who was the little kid on the original Lost in Space TV show. Played the little boy, and there's also Osaka Pop Stars version, cover version of that song, and that was off of a a compilation called Covered in Punk last that came out last year, which is punk covers of stuff from the Dr. Demento radio show and albums. We have a vinyl debut. This is hard because it's a metal metallic. It's printed on a foil jacket, but it's an album by Pepper, Pink Crustaceans and Good Vibrations. Man, I'm having trouble saying things all of a sudden. Man, I'm probably just talking so long. Anyway, Pink Splatter vinyl, and there's no way. Oh, there, that's what it looks like. The Bohemian Rhapsody soundtrack. Double picture disc, you can see here, and it's the, soundtrack to that movie. Bunch of Queen stuff. Rhymes, it says. This is Leanne Rhymes' covers album, and she does a bunch of stuff that you'd expect, like one of her songs, the Merle Haggard song, and songs that like were hits for like Buck Owens and Willie Nelson. There's a Freddie Fender song on here. But she also, like, she starts it off with, look, Pride and Joy by Stevie Ray Vaughan. And she's also got, and I just gotta show this to you because I know you won't believe it, Wonderwall. She's covering that. Anyway, I'm really kind of curious to know what she does with all that stuff. I bet it's pretty interesting. Todd Rundgren, 4-LP box set, the complete U.S. Bearsville and Warner Brothers singles. Obviously, it's a giant box set. Probably got a big book in there, and a lot of people are excited about that, I think. It's Ramones album. This is live stuff that was in one of the box sets recently, the first time you could get it on vinyl. Here's a white vinyl version of Robin's album Body Talk. It's in a gatefold cover, has a download, and it includes like a acoustic version that's not of what song, Stars Forever, that's not on the regular album. This is one of three titles that Rough Guide is releasing this year. They always have download cards, and often you get a ton of extra stuff on those download cards. This live Salvation Army album was recorded right before they had to change their name to 3 o'clock, so the Paisley Underground band. This Scatolites album from 1996, which was right in the heart of that like ska resurgence, so of course you need a record by them there. Here's an album of demos from 1974 by Brett Smiley. Those demos resulted in some label giving him just a ridiculous amount of money for his next project. Here is Soccer Mommy's first EP. It's the first time that this has been available on vinyl, and she's made a nice gatefold cover for it. We see a lot of previously unreleased stuff on Record Store Day, of course, but it's rare that somebody would choose to release a whole like studio album, like a full-on album, on Record Store Day. But that is what Sun O, the doom metal band, has done. And here we are, that's gonna come on CD as well. It will be available after Record Store Day and other stores or whatever, and digitally too for those who need that. But your first chance to get it is Record Store Day. Now, this is cool. So I can feel on the CD, there's a little, one of those fake Obi strips on the CD. There's also one here on the record, although that's not fake. That's a real Obi strip because it doesn't go around the back. It's actually just on that one side. So what's the deal here? This is all analog. It was recorded analog, mixed analog, cut, all analog. Never reached the digital domain until they made the master for the CD. So what that means is, first of all, they had to play everything just like what you hear on here. Also, you have none of that sound degradation that you get. That's just part of the digital process. There's no way to avoid it. And I know a lot of people, if not most people, think they can't hear the difference. Oh, I can't hear the difference. Like, my ears aren't good enough to hear the difference between different things. I think it's like, like art, like even if you haven't taken art history or aren't an artist yourself, you can kind of like tell which is what's better than something else, or like you're cooking or something, you know, where you're like the spices, I can't identify how much oregano is in that, but I know it tastes good. So I think when it comes to music, if you have some, if the sound quality's not there, or if it's in the case of you know, how much information is removed by the digital process, I think there's, like, you feel it. You may not understand it, you may not know why, but you can feel it. And I think if you have ever been around somebody when you've taken some taken a recording that they know really well, they've listened to a lot of times. You've probably all done this, right? Somebody's got like a favorite thing and they're used to listening to it on their phone or shitty earbuds or whatever. And then you sit them down at your house and play it for them on a record, and they're always like, whoa, I didn't know it could sound like that. You know, that's the thing. So why not start off? Why not start off with something that's gonna sound good? Here's the first vinyl pressing of the Stars, not the Stars, just plain Stars. Stars EP, Sad Robots. It's a double live album from Stereophonics, 2005. And here's a Swerve Driver covers EP on white vinyl. Teyana Taylor's song, Gonna Love Me, is on here in two versions. There's the regular version, and there's also a remix with Ghostface Killah, Method Man, and Raekwon. There's also a different song on the side B. Ana Tijoux is a rapper from Chile, I believe, and this is the first time this has been on vinyl, and she does like really political, like Latin hip hop. It's white vinyl. And for those of you who haven't decided what your Frank piece is yet this year, it might be a good choice, because I mean, she's rapping in Spanish, so it's kind of, but it'd be kind of like a cool bridge. So you know, like if you like world music and don't listen to a lot of hip-hop, might be cool. If you've heard it in video games and TV shows that her stuff's been in, that's cool. Or you could also be bridging from hip-hop into international music, or you could just be like, man, there's so few women releases by women on Record Store Day anyway, I gotta buy something by just to, like, you know, represent. Here's a 10th anniversary reissue of Tosca, No Hassle. And there's four extra tracks that weren't on the original version, and it's on blue vinyl. There's a U2 EP, and what's cool about it is that the first half of the A-side is stuff that, like, the music they had before their concerts. They played before the concerts on their 2018 tour. There's also a live version of New Year's Day and a couple remixes. The Best of Towns Van Zandt. It's a double album, gatefold vinyl, gatefold cover, I mean. You can't really have, I mean, gatefold vinyl would wreck it, I guess, so I could play that. And it's on Tiger's Eye vinyl, which, if you've never seen that combination of colors, it's pretty cool. You might remember the Where the Action Is LA Nuggets box set, which was a bunch of stuff from the, I think it was four CDs, but it's all stuff from like the 65 to 68 period. Bunch of bands that you know. Anyway, this has been, it's been distilled down to two LPs for Record Store Day, which has happened with other records in the Nuggets series. And I want you to take a look at the track listing here, because if you'll notice, it's a lot of bands you've heard of, but it's not the most obvious songs. And if you look at who produced it. If you know people who do or who are great at producing archival releases, you will understand why it's so well chosen. Anyhow, what I think is pretty cool about this is that, again, it's, you know, this is not obvious stuff, which means that if you have a lot of, if you're the type of person who would want to buy this, you probably have a lot of that, the more obvious songs already in your collection. So that'll be cool. John Paul White has a new album out this month, and the Record Store Day version includes a 7-inch with two additional songs on it that otherwise unreleased. He used to be in a band called The Civil Wars, and the other half of that band, Joy Williams, she also has an album coming out this spring. There is, it's not a Record Store Day thing, but I think there's an indie exclusive version of it, so just keep your eyes open for that. Marty Wilson Piper was in The Church, and here's a double album of his being reissued. First time on vinyl, I think. It's the band Winter, the EP. I really like the artwork on this one, and it's mint-colored vinyl, so that'll probably look pretty great, especially when you know put it on Instagram next to the right next to that cover. I'm gonna do the 10 inches now, a bunch of them anyway. Here is something for Cheech and Chong. It's another version of Up in Smoke, and the label is Scratch and Sniff, and smells like, I don't know, like a plant, sort of. Here's this Doors Live in Venice. These are their first live recordings, and it's the same thing that was in a box set last year. So if you didn't want the box set because it was expensive and you didn't care about like the book and the CD and all the other like cool stuff, photos and things that were, I forget what it was, but it was like that thick. If you didn't want all that stuff and you just want the record, here it is. Here's a Woody Guthrie record, and this is kind of interesting. It's like from, you know, there's a demo of his, and like he had wrote a couple songs about living in this shitty apartment in New York. And so other people kind of combined them in different ways. And so like Ani DiFranco has a version of it with Tom Morello, believe it or not. And there's also one with Jeff Tweedy, but Ani's version is called Old Man Trump. And the Old Man Trump in here is actually, it's Fred Trump, to bring it kind of into the 21st century. And U.S. Elevator is Johnny Irion is in that, and he is married to Woody Guthrie's granddaughter. And when they were at Bull Moose to perform, they were really pretty awesome. Here's a Japan reissue, red vinyl. Another Jethro Tull 10-inch. There have been a whole series of these that seems like there's one to accompany almost every one of the box sets. The Stormwatch box set will be the next one. North Sea Oil is the song off of that. So keep your eyes open for the record and the box set. You know, it'll have a five, I don't know the details yet, but I mean, it'll be a 5.1 remix, and it'll be awesome. And if you're a Tall collector, definitely get the box set. Just keep getting those box sets as they come out, because they go out of print fairly quickly. And then if you like change your mind later, like I did about Minstrel in the Gallery, I skipped it for some dumbass reason. I don't know why. I skipped it, and now it's like real expensive, and you know, that just sucks. The Magpie Salute. 10-inch here, 10-inch picture disc. It's two versions of Echo and the Bunnymen song. I can't believe I forgot to get it here to show you, but there is a Chris Robinson Brotherhood record, just mentioning it because Chris Robinson's brother is not in the Brotherhood, he's in Magpie Salute. But that's two songs, I think, from the upcoming Chris Robinson Brotherhood album, which will have an indie exclusive also, and it's in the gatefold cover, so it'll be a nice package, although I should be showing it to you. Van Morrison, these are, you know, some extra songs, alternate takes from the like expanded Astral Weeks album. The Rolling Stones She's a Rainbow 10-inch. And I should mention there's a couple other Rolling Stones reissues, but, you know, Abco didn't get them here in time, so I can't show them to you. I assume we'll have them on Record Store Day. And here's a 07 10-inch, and side A is a new mix, and side B, it's the first time that that song's been available on a physical format. Charlatans, Us, and Us Only reissue. I'm pretty sure it's never been available on vinyl in the U.S. before. Maybe nowhere ever, because it's a 1999 album, and you know, kind of in that vinyl dead zone. Crystal clear vinyl. Nice heavy sleeve. But a cheap. This is the CD booklet for the Gong live album at Bataclan in 1973. It's coming out on vinyl for the first time on green and purple vinyl. Two LPs. And if you're not, you know, if like you're into prog and haven't experienced Gong before, this might be a good place to start. I would say they're closest to Hawkwind. In fact, one of the keyboard player from Gong ended up was in Hawkwind for a while, or vice versa. But it's that like space rock side of prog, except they're not as dark as Hawkwind can be. They're more, you know, like look, that's them, right? That's the kind of thing they would think is cool. Maybe they're partly kidding when they do stuff like that, but there's this whole mythology they have around pothead pixies who travel in flying teapots, and they communicate telepathically through something called Radio Gnome Invisible. So yeah, if you know, there's like Emerson, Lake and Palmer, and there's Rush, which I'll show you the picture disc in just a minute, and there's Pink Floyd and Yes, and probably some other prog, and there's those two psych compilations I told you about. So you know, if you're kind of in that world, you should know you would probably be into Gong, I think. Here's an Elton John live album, live from Moscow. These are from a concert he did in 1979, obviously, in the Soviet Union. And I don't think there's a CD version of this coming out. I checked, and the only thing I could find were bootlegs on Amazon. And this had been broadcast on the BBC, so that's probably the source of those bootlegs. You know, who knows what quality, probably, you know, MP3s to whatever. Anyhow, this is done by his real record label. They got the tapes from the BBC, licensed them the whole bit, mastered here in Portland by Bob Ludwig, and then the vinyl lacquers were cut by Sean McGee at Abbey Road. So this is as good as it's gonna get. It's on a clear vinyl, nice anti-static sleeves. An essay about what the whole thing was. So here's the deal, it's two LPs. The first one is Elton solo, it's just his voice and either piano or electric piano. And on the second record, percussionist Ray Cooper comes out to join him. But he's not like playing a full drum kit, it's like, you know, congas, or this one song where he's like wailing on a gong. It's a little distracting, but I mean, it's cool. Anyway, if you're an Elton John fan, you know, you've heard these songs a gazillion times, but these are really, really cool versions. So if you're into Elton John, you will really enjoy this. And there's some pretty cool covers, and you also get a sense of how great, if you forgot how good a piano player he is, well, this will remind you. And he does some cool, there's some cool stuff, cool covers on there, like he figures out in the Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting. He obviously figures out that Saturday is kind of like the guitar opening to Pinball Wizard. Da na 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 na. It's like same suspension. So he just like he puts Pinball Wizard, like he sings the verse of Pinball Wizard just kind of randomly in the middle of Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting, and then he goes back to Saturday Night, and then he goes back to Pinball Wizard. It's really pretty fun. And there's a couple Beatles covers at the end, including the obvious one that you would do if you were doing a concert in the USSR. In fact, you know, McCartney. Well, anyhow, speaking of great stuff that you got to get if you are a fan of the artist, John Lennon. This is the raw studio mixes of stuff from Imagine, and It's thick. When you get this, you're going to say, this is real thick. Why? It feels like there's a second record in here. No, there's not a second record. It's just that they did some really cool things. There is a nice, heavy reproduction of the War Is Over If You Want It, Love and Peace from John and Yoko. Real nice poster. You might, like, this is the kind of thing you might take to a post, to like a framing shop and have it steamed and hung up or something. It's that nice. Also, the record is in a good anti-static sleeve, super heavy vinyl. I listened to the whole thing at like midnight last night, and it's real quiet pressing. It's really clean looking, like it's great, well-pressed vinyl. They do include, like you could put it in here, but obviously the record's better off in that anti-static sleeve. Liner notes, track stuff. So, but what the heck is it anyway? These are like the basic tracks of the songs that ended up on Imagine. It's stuff. It's on the box set. In fact, if you didn't buy the Imagine box set last fall when it came out in November, this will probably make you want to buy that. This is that good. It's kind of like what you would have heard if you were in the room, right? So it's got his scratch vocal on there. They don't have any like reverb or the slapback echo he liked to use. The like string overdubs are not there. There's a harmonica overdub, but like that's the only thing. And you only notice it because it overlaps with his vocal a little bit. And John Lennon was like one of the most amazing people ever in any kind of way you could measure a person, but he could not sing and play harmonica at the same time. I do not believe that. Anyway, it's great. Everything that could be good about this is good about it. All right, here's the Office Space soundtrack gatefold cover. It's a hip-hop soundtrack, if you're not familiar with it, and it is on red vinyl, it's almost like magenta, kind of, when I hold it up to the light here. Cool picture of that. Oh, yeah, where's the... Here's the sticker that's on the outside of it. And so it's Cool Keith's on here, by the way. You saw that nice, really cool animated etched record with all earlier. The Life of Brian soundtrack, Monty Python movie, of course, which, hey, there's a connection with the John Lennon thing, right? Because George Harrison financed this, right? And George Harrison plays on a few songs on here. These guys everywhere, right? Anyway, it is same artwork as the original one, same back cover, but let me give you a closer look at the actual picture disc. So the picture disc is the same as the cover. The stuff that's like around, I'll show you that in a second. Here's the back side. Now there's an insert, here we go, which does not have the same exact stuff as the record sleeve, the inner sleeve of the original. So that's cool stuff. And you'll notice all this stuff around here is different than what was on the original cover. And there is, if you've seen the movie, that will make sense to you. Charlie Parker with strings, alternate takes, made up to look like a, vintage record, blue vinyl. There's a little bit of like white marbling happening there. And I've noticed that there's a lot more jazz coming out of the Universal jazz labels, Verve and Impulse. And I know that Blue Note just hired the guy who did all the great stuff for Resonance Records. So I know he's doing some cool stuff over at Blue Note, and I'm not sure if Blue Note is separate or if he's also working on stuff like this, but anyway, a lot of good jazz coming out. A lot of good jazz reissues coming out of Verve, Blue Note, Impulse. So keep your eyes out for those. In fact, like, just I saw some of the stuff that's coming out in May, and I was like, wow, that's really pretty cool, including Oliver Nelson, The Blues and Abstract Truth, which is something I've been like thinking, man, that needs a vinyl release. I don't know whose idea that was, but we're grateful for it. Here's remixes from Roxy Music's first album. And as you can see, the cover is, outtakes from the photo shoot that produced the cover of the first album, and these are not like Steven Wilson remixes that are, you know, these are like, you know, more club-oriented DJ type remixes. They're technically 12 inches, but they run at 33 1/3 RPM, and so yeah, they managed to make some kind of weird music, really weird. It's interesting, and not just if you're into like, yeah, I guess you could dance to it. Anyhow, here's the Rush Picture Disc, Hemispheres. There is the back cover, and I'm going to take it out of the sleeve here just so you can really see how nice this looks. Nice and glossy. This is a really cool thing. The guy over there is definitely going to be psyched to get this. Let me put it back in the sleeve there. What's left? What's left? Oh, yeah. Marty Stewart. Now, there's not enough country at Record Store Day in general. Not enough country, I think, the pop country, I don't think gets released, even physical releases as much anymore. So it's great that we have this Marty Stewart record. It's part of the Icon series, which is one of the compilation series, is greatest hits type things that Universal puts out. Supposedly, these are autographed. They didn't waste an autographed one on me. Black vinyl, feels nice and heavy. Sublime. This is stuff, you know, from the Everything Under the Sun box set. It's a like single LP compilation. It's a marbly red and orange record. That looks pretty good, doesn't it? And it does, like the other, seems like they always do this with the Sublime stuff for Record Store Days. They have a nice, they put everything on an insert for you. Okay, Weezer. I showed you the Teal album earlier. I think this is Dusty Gems and Raw Nuggets, and these are like the bonus tracks that were on the bonus disc that came out with the Blue album. It is on, probably, hope for it, blue vinyl. It's translucent, and there's a little bit of like a darker blue marbling in there. It's pretty cool. We even hold it up to light. And again, we have an insert, which is cool because you don't have to worry about your sleeve getting torn up. We have reached Z, and this is the last release of the video. It's Frank Zappa record that was originally, well, it was only released ever on cassette through him, and so it's a bunch of his, you know, guitar stuff, right? That's what, you know, the guitar world, according to Frank Zappa. So this is his guitar stuff now. There you go. Copy what it originally looked like. The liner notes here do, it's his original liner notes, so he talks about like what the state of these recordings were at the time. You know, what? So some of them say they will be on a forthcoming guitar box, and I went through my, you know, the three guitar albums, but they actually came out before this did, so hey, I don't know. Maybe some of this stuff has, it's definitely not been on vinyl. Some of the stuff maybe might be the only place you can get it, but don't hold me to that. Anyway, another Record Store Day thing from Frank Zappa you need to get. And the last thing I want to show you, just because I'm real proud of how it turned out, even though I had nothing to do with it except for saying, yes, she's awesome. She's a great artist. She'll do a fantastic job. So one of our people, Jessenia, if you shop in the Portland Bull Moose, you know her, made this print. It's awesome. We'll be giving an album out on Record Store Day, and I think it just turned out great. The Life of Brian soundtrack, Monty Python movie, of course, which, hey, there's a connection with the John Lennon thing, right? Because George Harrison financed this, right? And George Harrison plays on a few songs on here. It's guys everywhere, right? Anyway, it is same artwork as the original one, same back cover, but let me give you a closer look at the actual picture disc. So the picture disc is the same as the cover. The stuff that's like around, I'll show you that in a second. Here's the back side. Now there's an insert, here we go, which does not have the same exact stuff as the record sleeve, the inner sleeve of the original. So that's cool stuff. And you'll notice all this stuff around here is different than what was on the original cover. And there is, if you've seen the movie, that will make sense to you. Charlie Parker with strings, alternate takes, made up to look like a, you know, vintage record. Blue vinyl, there's a little bit of like white marbling happening there. And I've noticed that there's a lot more jazz coming out of the Universal jazz labels, Verve and Impulse. And I know that Blue Note just hired the guy who did all the great stuff for Resonance Records. So I know he's doing some cool stuff over at Blue Note, and I'm not sure if Blue Note is separate or if he's also working on stuff like this. But anyway, a lot of good jazz coming out. A lot of good jazz reissues coming out of Verve, Blue Note, Impulse. So keep your eyes out for those. In fact, like, just I saw some of the stuff that's coming out in May, and I was like, wow, that's really pretty cool, including Oliver Nelson, The Blues and Abstract Truth, which is something I've been like thinking, man, that needs a vinyl release. I don't know whose idea that was, but we're grateful for it. Here's a remixes from Roxy Music's first album. And as you can see, the cover is, you know, outtakes from the photo shoot that produced the cover of the first album. And these are not like Stephen Wilson remixes that are, you know, these are like, you know, more club-oriented DJ type remixes. They're technically 12 inches, but they run at 33 1/3 RPM. And so, yeah, they managed to make some kind of weird music really weird. It's interesting, and not just if you're into like, yeah, I guess you could dance to it. Anyhow, here's the Rush Picture Disc. Hemispheres, there is the back cover, and I'm going to take it out of the sleeve here just so you can really see how nice this looks. Nice and glossy. This is a really cool thing. The guy over there is definitely going to be psyched to get this. Let me put it back in the sleeve there. What's left? Oh, yeah, Marty Stewart. Now, there's not enough country at Record Store Day in general. Not enough country, I think, the pop country, I don't think gets released, even physical releases as much anymore. So it's great that we have this Marty Stewart record. It's part of the Icon series, which is one of the compilation series, is greatest hits type things that Universal puts out. Supposedly, these are autographed. They didn't waste an autographed one on me. Black vinyl, feels nice and heavy. Sublime. This is stuff, you know, from the Everything Under the Sun box set. It's a like single LP compilation. It's a marbly red and orange record. That looks pretty good, doesn't it? And it does, like the other, seems like they always do this with the Sublime stuff for Record Store Days. They have a nice, they put everything on an insert for you. Okay, Weezer. I showed you the Teal album earlier. I think this is Dusty Gems and Raw Nuggets, and these are like the bonus tracks that were on the bonus disc that came out with the Blue album. It is on, probably, hope for it, blue vinyl. It's translucent, and there's a little bit of like a darker blue marbling in there. It's pretty cool. We even pull it up to light. And again, we have an insert, which is cool because you don't have to worry about your sleeve getting torn up. We have reached Z, and this is the last release of the video. It's Frank Zappa record that was originally, was the only released ever on cassette through him, and so it's a bunch of his, you know, guitar stuff, right? That's what, you know, the guitar world, according to Frank Zappa. So this is his guitar stuff now. There you go. Copy what it originally looked like. The liner notes here do, it's his original liner notes, so he talks about like what the state of these recordings were at the time. You know, what? So some of them say they will be on a forthcoming guitar box. And I went through my, you know, the three guitar albums, but they actually came out before this did, so hey, I don't know. Maybe some of this stuff has, it's definitely not been on vinyl. Some of the stuff maybe might be the only place you can get it, but don't hold me to that. Anyway, another Record Store Day thing from Frank Zappa you need to get. And the last thing I want to show you, just because I'm real proud of how it turned out, even though I had nothing to do with it except for saying, yes, she's awesome. She's a great artist. She'll do a fantastic job. So one of our people, Jasenia, if you shop in the Portland Bull Moose, you know her, made this print. It's awesome. We'll be giving an album out on Record Store Day. And I think it just turned out great. Or you can stop watching now. I know nobody watches the like sign-off portion. So, but yeah, thanks for watching. Do appreciate it. Hope that you have a great time on Record Store Day. And this is Chris Brown from Bull Moose saying, you know, Brown out.